Hello, this is a crash course on JSX. We try to understand what JSX is, its syntax, and how to use JSX in our project. By the way, you can do React without JSX, but I would not recommend it because it's quite painful, and I'll show you why. Also, this is the second part of the React series. I'll provide a link to the playlist so you can check it out, the whole series, and welcome to techsith tutorials. First of all, what is JSX stands for? It stands for JavaScript XML. So does it mean XML is back in the fashion? Apparently so. What it does, it allows you to write HTML looking syntax that gets transformed into lightweight JavaScript objects. In order to understand the syntax, we can go to this website, babbeljs.io/REPL. And here on the left side, you can write your JSX. And on the right side, it will convert your JSX into the JavaScript. So let's say if you want to write a particular tag into HTML, let's say if it's a div tag, I would say div and hello and close a tag. And as you can see on the right side, it created this JavaScript syntax with saying create a React element, and it's passing three arguments inside. The first is the name of the element, which is div. The second one is null. This is actually, you can pass property into this div tag, attributes for HTML. And the last is the content that you pass, which is hello here. So if you were not gonna use a JSX, you would have to write this inside React. Now let's pass some property here. So I'm going to say name equal to techsith. And as you can see, instead of null, now I have name equal to techsith. So if I wanna pass any string, it would do this. But if I wanna pass anything but string, because this way you can only pass strings. So if I say, if I wanna do true, it would say true, but it's actually a string. So if I wanna pass the Boolean, I would simply say this name, which means true. And as you can see, it says name equal to true. If I wanna pass false, I would have to do this. I would have to use a curly bracket. So any non-string, I have to use this. So I can say false here and I'll get it. Similarly, I can say numbers. One would translate into one number here. Now here, inside this curly brackets, you can actually use JavaScript expressions. I can do a little math here. I can say 1 plus 1, and it does 1 plus 1 here, but it would eventually transform, because this would get transformed into HTML ultimately. So it would transform into a div tag with attribute name equal to 2, and value of that element would be hello. So let's look at it by creating a new project. For creating app, I have installed create React app package. So I can say create app and then name of the project in a command line. So I'm going to say learn JSX, and it will take a few minutes. And if you want to know more about creating using this package, I have a first tutorial on React, which we looked at this, and I'll provide a link here. And by the way, it will take a few minutes to create it. All right, so it has created this project, and I'm just gonna do cd learn JSX and open the project. In the source folder, I have the main app component, which is this. And so if I compile the project by doing npm start, it will load whatever it's in the app component on there. So when it loads it, it loads this logo and the text, which is here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna remove all of it and write our div that we just did. And I can say name equal to 1 plus 1, and it would say hello, and save this. And it should render hello here. Now let's look at the property to see if it does have the name attribute. So inside the console, if I look at inspect this element, I can see that div name equal to 2. So it is actually transforming that 1 plus 1 into 2. So here, actually, I can use any JavaScript expression that is available, a percentage sign or divide or anything. But I cannot use statements like if statements or for loop or anything like that. I can use ID, which is the HTML attribute. So I can say ID equal to name, and it would show up here, ID equal to name. But if I want to use class, for example, class as name, I have to use class name. I cannot use class here. And that is because in XML, if you knew, we are not encouraged to use class or for keyword inside XML as a property. So we should not use it. So what we do is we use class name, and it will eventually get converted into class. So if I save it here and look at it, it has converted into class equal to name. Similarly, if I want to use for, which is also not recommended, I would have to use HTML for, and that should convert into for. And it would get converted into for. So you need to know these two things. Let's go back to Babel, and here I can have child element. So I can have a div, and inside a div, I can have, let's say, H1 element, hello. And when I render it, it actually creates element, React element, and inside, as a value, it would create another React element. So as you can see, if I have a giant HTML that I wanna create, and if I don't wanna use JSX, then I would have to do this inside React, and it would be quite painful because I have to have a nested create element statements like this. And to try it out, so instead of doing this, let's say if I copy this part here, go back to my project, and instead of returning this JSX, I can replace this with React create element and save it and see what it renders. All right, so it does render this hello. And as you can see, it's H1 element. So you have a div inside and I have an H1 element inside. So this is how it really works. You don't really have to use JSX. You can just do this, but it's quite painful. I mean, this is only two elements and it's becoming unreadable. So I should keep it. Instead of this, I can copy this part. And it would produce the same result. Now, instead of H1, this text, I can actually create a function component. And to do that, I can simply write a function. I can say function say hello, and it returns this. And now here, instead of HTML tag, I can say hello. And it would be the same thing. So it would compile the same thing. So this function actually behaves like a component itself. So you can have component inside a component like that. So that's all about JSX. As I said, it's pretty easy to learn. And if you have any question, do let me know. And I hope you learned something from this tutorial. And if you did, please take a few seconds of your life and try to like this video and provide a nice comment. Thank you.